Felicity Ward is back, baby. It's been 3 years since this Aussie comedian turned UK resident has graced our stages, but she is back and she is raring to go.
We got married and, mate, they're not kidding. It is the best day of your life. If anyone is thinking about getting married, do it, even if you're not that into the person, honestly. What a party! It is worth a lifetime of misery. Get on it. And when you get married, everyone asks you the same question. They're like, do you guys feel different now? I'm like, yes, we feel very poor.
Very true. And she's back on Aussie soil and joins us now live in the studio. Felicity, welcome to the show.
Hey, guys.
Look, a lot's happened since we last saw you.
A little bit, yeah. Yeah, I've become a British citizen.
Wow.
Don't worry, I haven't given up the passport. I'm not an idiot.
No.
Just both countries seem really hostile. I'm like, well, let's have passports in both just in case it turns.
Very smart.
Yeah. You also created a whole new human.
Yeah, created a person, no biggie.
Yeah.
I don't know what you've done with your body, Beau, but made a person. Yeah, he's unreal. He's 2.5. You know those creepy mums that are like, oh, my God, he's the love of my life and I don't need anyone. I'm a creepy mum, 100%.
Embrace it.
Sniff his head every day.
Yeah, and showing photos. I never said I'd be that guy. You see people with kids, you're like, look at my kids. You're like, miss me with that.
Yeah.
Now, we were at the Logies and it was just people showing photos of their kids.
That's all you want to do. And you want to find other parents because you don't even have to say hello. They're like, how old? And it's straight out.
Yep.
Yeah.
Straight
out.
There we go.
Yeah.
Right.
But the thing is, we know we're annoying, but we've got to find other like-minded people.
That's right.
Because it's an addiction. Mm. We're unwell.
Yep.
Yeah.
Mm. Now, you've based a new comedy show, She's Back, Baby, on motherhood.
Yes.
How is motherhood treating you? I know you love beautiful, your beautiful baby boy, but there were some challenges, weren't there, during pregnancy?
Yeah, I mean, like, the pregnancy was fantastic. It took me a long time to conceive, or took us a long time to conceive, and that was, like, the hardest because they tell you... I was raised that you should be paranoid that you're pregnant every month.
Mm. Yes.
Every month I'm like, oh, God, it's happened. It's like, you haven't had sex. No. I think I'm pregnant. And then you go, OK, I'm ready. We can put the contraception away. And then it was, like, years. Mm. So that was really upsetting and a thing that I wasn't prepared for. Pregnancy was unreal. The birth was incredible. And then he came along and I was like, oh, I don't actually know if I am ready for this, even though that's what I wanted. And I was terrified and I didn't want to... You know how they're like, just sleep when the baby sleeps? It's like, what if your baby sleeps 3 minutes or 6 hours or wakes up only when you're in the shower? So I got postnatal depression really, really badly.
Oh,
and
wow.
It's like regular depression but with more responsibility. And I went back to work. Like, part of it was I took the job because I had postnatal depression and I thought, I'll just go back to work and then I don't have a baby, which, funnily enough, is not how it works. So there was a drama series on the ABC called Wakefield and I got the audition when he was 12 days old.
Oh, my gosh.
And
wow.
I have never been asked before that day to audition for an Australian drama.
Wow.
And the first one came through, I'm like... Sorry, what? And, like, my boobs are down here, everything's covered in milk. I'm like, I could probably do an audition. And then, don't know how, but got the part and then had to start when he was... We landed when he was 9 weeks old and then, like, pumping on set and, or, you know, still feeding through the night and it was... Not ideal.
It's funny because I've kind of had some dark moments too, but when you're in it, you just feel like you're never going to get out of it. Now you've got some perspective and looking back, are you just like, this is just so hilarious. How did I even survive it? You're talking about the milk down your chest and, you know, and auditioning it with a baby that's 12 days old.
I've turned into a full hardcore missionary about how incredible people are who give birth because it is, one, it's insane. I was really lucky, and if there's anyone who is struggling and they're in their early days of motherhood, try to find someone else who's got, like, a one-year-old because I had a mate. I sent her a text message when I was, like, when Frankie was 2 weeks old, and I was like, this is so hard. And she sent me a photo that she took when her baby was a month old. She took a photo of herself bawling her eyes out. She goes, this is the photo I took of myself so I would remind myself never to have another child. And she's since got past that, but it really helped. I'm like, okay, other people find...
Oh, yeah.
Because you think you think that everyone else is, oh, my God.
Like it's a Huggies commercial where everyone's kissing their babies gently and, yeah, there's
soft music
playing.
I remember when he was, like, 6 weeks old and I was on the WhatsApp group with, the mother's group, and someone said, I burst into tears because someone said, has anyone got a good casserole recipe? I'm like, who's cooking? What do you mean? Who's reading a recipe?
Who's got the time for that?
Oh, my God. And they were like, oh, because our baby had colic and it was just... And it was the dead of English winter. So, the sun gets up at 10 a.m. and goes to bed at 2 p.m.
Yeah.
So the nights are long.
Don't forget, you also had a pandemic thrown in as well. You had a few challenges heading your way.
Well, that was after. By the time that hit, it didn't even touch the side. But of course there's a pandemic. What do I care?
Hey, let's talk about your little man, your beautiful little boy, Frankie. He features in your stand-up.
He does feature.
Quite prominently. Are you mindful of, when he grows up, of how he's going to look at you or look at himself or other people talk about it?
Yeah. Well, look, I don't... There's not a lot that I report on him. It's more about my experience. There are some very funny things that he does that I won't talk about. And then there's some that I will. There's
some of it's so line ball though. Like half the time when my kids do stupid stuff, I'm like, oh, can I tell that story?
Yes.
You're like, it's such good content, but I can't.
It's good content.
Great material.
Hey, mate, I just want to have a chat about your IP.
I'm just trying to put food on the table, mate.
Come on,
take one for the team.
Most of it, it's about my experience with having a kid rather than stuff that he's done. Like the first time you ever drop your kid off at daycare, if you walk there, and then you've got to walk back with an empty pram and you look absolutely mad. And you're like looking down everyone going, no, I've got one, I promise. Now I just lean into it. Now I just walk around going, one day my prince will... Have you got a baby?
Stick the dog in as well.
Yeah.
Well, thank you so much for joining us.
Not at all.
Star.
Still as funny as ever.
You shut your face.
Oh, we can't wait to see you back up on stage.
It's good to see you back. And, flying that Aussie flag.
I'm pumped, mate. Sydney, Melbourne and Hobart, I'm coming for you.
So good. Best place. Well,
thing.
You can book tickets to Felicity's show at felicityward.com. Always a pleasure, Felicity. Thank you so much for joining us. And good luck.
Absolute delight.
Thank you, slaying it, lady.
Come to the show, babes. I'll get you some tickets. I'll get you a 2-for-1.
Oh. Beautiful. Thank you, darling. Have a great day.